Because there's a demonic grace that the enemy has raised in this end time. A demonic grace, a grace that is from hell, a grace that is reading many children of God in hell, a grace that is reading the church of God astray. The reason why we can see the churches of God backsliding and lukewarm, the way that you can see the church that is looking, or the image that you see in the church, that is the result of the grace that they have received. And therefore, there is a grace that the enemy has released, a grace from hell, a grace of deception, a demonic grace. Which grace? You find that everyone is saying that we are living in the grace. We are in grace. I will save by grace. I will be saved by grace. There's this proverb that people are singing everywhere. Even when you go to club, even when you go to disco, even when you go to the drunkard, even when you go to the harlot, even when you go to all the people, you hear them saying that we shall be saved by grace. Therefore, don't speak to me. Don't tell me anything about that, because we shall be saved by grace, and we are saved by grace. You see, this is what they are saying. Everyone, even thief, we shall be saved by grace. Drunkard, we shall be saved by grace. A prostitute, we shall be saved by grace. When you go to the church, we shall be saved by grace. But which grace is this that people are saying all over the world? People are saying, even the people of the world are just saying, we shall be saved by grace. Which grace is this? We are looking, we are reading in the Bible of Titus, in the book of Titus 2, Titus chapter 2, verse 11. Titus chapter 2, verse 11. The Bible says this. The Bible says this. For the grace of God that brings salvation has appeared to all men. You see, for the grace of God that brings salvation to all men has appeared to all men. The grace of God that brings salvation. There is a grace that brings salvation. But that grace that I'm speaking about, the first demonic grace, is not bringing salvation. But it is bringing people to hell. It is causing people to hell instead of bringing them into salvation. Here, what the word of God is saying. For the grace of God that brings salvation has appeared to all men. And it teaches us, to say no to ungodliness and to worldly passion, and to live a self-controlled life, a life upright and a godly life in the present of this age, where we wait for the blessed hope of the glorious appearing of the great God and Savior, Jesus Christ. You see, what is the meaning of the true grace? This is what the meaning of the true grace, that the true grace has appeared to all men, that it teaches us to say no to ungodliness. This is the true grace that God is speaking about this hour, the true grace that should be in the churches, the true grace that should be everywhere, the true grace that the preachers should be preaching, the true grace that teaches the people of God to say no to ungodly, to say no to worldliness, to say no to the passions and to the lust of this world. But when you see the kind of grace that is being preached today in the churches, the kind of grace that people are receiving and being saved, getting saved and living in a false grace, that you are going to heaven when you are still walking in immorality, when you are still walking in lies, when you are still walking in worldliness, that grace is not teaching you the godliness way. That grace is not teaching you to say no to sin, because the true grace that God is speaking of is speaking of a grace that teaches us to say no to ungodliness. That is the true grace. That is the true grace that teaches us to fear God. The true grace that teaches us to fear God and to walk in Him, in His holiness. This is the true grace that God is saying. But the false grace that has been released by the enemy, it is a grace that is leading them to hell. It is a passport. It is a visa to hell, whereby they are still going, they are still marching even with your Bible, they are still marching even with your Bible and saying that we shall be saved by grace. They are using the grace of God as an excuse of what they are doing, as an excuse of covering their sin, as an excuse of walking through immorality, of walking through in wilderness. Because the Bible have said well here in the book of Titus that the true grace of God, it teaches to say no to ungodliness, it teaches to say no to the worldly passions. True grace, when the true grace of God come upon your life, you will separate yourself from the wilderness. You will separate yourself away from the worldly passions, the desires of the body, the lust, the unfaithfulness, the disobedience, the speaking of lies, the speaking and insult. You need to separate yourself from those things, because that is the grace grace that saves you. That is the grace that is revealed to save all people. The pure grace that will enter you to the kingdom of God is a grace that separates you from the world. It is a grace that separates you and it teaches you to say no to ungodly. A grace that teaches you to walk in righteousness of God. Because this grace that you see people are preaching even in their churches, it is called the false grace. False grace that is not teaching them the separation from the world. False grace that has now brought the world to the church. False grace that has now brought even the homosexuality are in the church because of the false grace that does not teach them to say no to ungodliness. This false grace that people are preaching, it is a false grace that has brought even witches in the church. It is a false grace that has brought even comedians, even people who are entertaining in the church behind the pulpit. This is called false grace, and it is raised by the devil to populate hell, to populate people from going ahead, and to increase carelessness Christian, and to increase lukewarmness in the church, and to increase the number of those who don't fear God, but they claim they are still in the church. Those are the people that you hear them saying that, "Don't judge me, God just look at heart." Those are the people that you hear saying that, "No, I am still doing those things because the grace of God will save me. I am still cheating, I'm still watching pornography, I'm still running and doing fornication, I'm still having adultery, another affairs, I'm still lying, because the Lord's grace will save me. All we shall be saved by grace. It is not by work." That is how they say. It is not by work. It is only by how? It is only by the grace of God and mercy. Which mercy? If that grace does not separate you, that is false grace. And that is false grace that is making many people to enter hell. The false grace of the devil, which is raised by the enemy, is still running many churches. Is still running big churches, but they are all heading to hell. Reason, my brother and my sister. Reason, all the world. Reason, all the church of God. Run away from the false grace. Run away from that false grace. The grace that does not teach you to separate from the world. The grace that does not teach you to fear God. The grace that does not teach women and men to fear God. Even young people. The grace that does not show a difference between you and the world. That is the false grace from hell. Because a Christian must have a difference between the world and between a Christian. A prostitute must have a difference between a Christian and a prostitute. This is the hour to subscribe to the kingdom of God. This is the hour to subscribe to this grace of God that teaches us to walk in holiness, that teaches us to fear God, that teaches us to walk in righteousness, that teaches us to separate from the world, that teaches us to fear God. This is the hour, because the grace that we have been given, it is just a channel that you may be saved. It is just a time that is running out that you may be saved. The grace that you have been given is the mercy to prepare. It is the grace to repent. It is the grace to humble ourselves and to rule and to walk upon the Holy Spirit and to check ourselves. This is the true grace of God that is in the church. The true grace that is in the true church is the grace that searches their heart, is the grace that searches their life. It is the grace that searches them and make them complete holy, and make them complete holy, righteous. The true grace, it makes them holy. It makes them fear God. It makes them walk in uprightness. It makes them fear God. It makes them look different from the world. That is the power of the true grace of God. But the false grace from hell, it doesn't make them appear different from the world.